Hello everyone, it's Rizal Di Valencia here. I have worked for Disney for 14 years as an animator, and I have worked on a lot of films, TV series, direct-to-video, direct-to-DVD, and stuff like that, and haven't drawn for a long time. And a friend of mine asked me to draw Little Mermaid, so I thought of why not, should I maybe just share how I approach it. Anyway, I'm using Photoshop here. And as a traditional animator, we used blue pencil to rough out our drawings. Like here, what I'm using is just a blue color. And then I'll just add another layer to kind of, you know, blocking in the lines. And every now and then I will show up what I'm copying. It's from, I think it's a Blu-ray cover or DVD cover. You see it once in a while. And at this part, I'm another layer and try to block in the lines before I paint it, before I put all the basic color. And it's been a while. At least I know how to use the Photoshop, and I still remember everything. Yeah, putting all these details. And you can rotate the canvas here. Just like when you draw on a piece of paper, you can move it around. Yeah. And it's very important not to really copy what you're copying. It's about the feel. You know, it has to have the same feeling of what you're copying. I assume you may notice here, it's not exactly what, you know, it looked like, but the feel is there, and that's more important than the copying the exact detail, exact measurement of everything. And for me, that's very important. Imagine that back in the days, we have to draw this so many times, you know, to do the action. And I'm a bit rusty now, but it's still there. Yeah. So I'm just doing a voiceover while I'm watching the video I've just made, because it's not really hard, it's not easy to actually draw and you talk at the same time. So right now and this part, yeah, I'm doing a lot of rotating the canvas, and now I started to block in the color. As you can see, I started with the skin and the hair, and you would notice that I paint outside. It's just easier to erase than slowly painting inside the lines. And I also made this video faster because it's gonna be boring for you guys, and I think this is like, you know, 400 times or something the speed of this. So I don't really draw this fast. Alright, so I'm just cleaning out the excess paint outside. Yeah. It's still not gonna be perfect, because I like the feel of, you know, someone actually drawing it. It's not, you know, like a machine. And maybe some people would just trace the drawing, but what's the point of that? It's also good to train your eye and hand coordination, looking at the drawing, the one you're copying. And now I know I already got the feel, so sometimes I just turn off the one I'm copying. It slows down my computer, I guess, when I'm editing this video. So, alright, now putting all the, these are all just main main colors, just blacking the colors, and I'm adjusting the tail there, and I like it to be a bit smaller or bigger compared to the one I'm copying. And here, yes, I'm putting the line, blackening it, because I actually forgot to do that. And the rock.
The rock.
Yeah, this will be rough, just to give me a bit of outline before I color it. And of course, I'm basic on the one I'm copying. Okay, now I'm adding the splash of water, and that's what I'm copying again. I saw another picture, and I just kind of use it to add the excess water splashes everywhere. Okay, now I'm adding a bit of a shade, the darker color. As you may notice on the layer, I'm just really making this very, very simple for me, and just changing the blending mode. It's the same color as the hair, but if you put in a multiply, it will become darker. And when it's too dark, you just lessen the opacity. And this part, I'm putting the highlight. Yes, just the same, but I'm putting color dodge for blending mode. And after that, I Gaussian blur it. Yeah, because back then in the 2Ds, it's not, we don't really try to make it like a 3D look. It's more like add a highlight there and a shadow there, and that's it. It would work already, because you have to draw this so many times. See, here I'm experimenting what kind of blending mode I should use. And then I'll blur it again. Now, where am I now? Let's go to the shell bra. I put some highlight there. Okay, I'm just trying to put some details on the lips. That's it. You can see Ariel's coming to life. Put a highlight in the eyes. I'm coloring now the tail. And these tails actually have a self-color line, which is like white. So, and I'll show you how I've done it. Just like select the line. Right now I'm just putting highlights. You know, those reflection. To make it look fishy and wet. And, okay, let's see. Just checking. Alright, see, I'm doing the waistline. Because it's gonna be I was thinking what to do with it, so okay, I take it out, put another layer, and I inverted it, so it became, the black became white. So I just need to add those white color and the highlights, and that's it. Similar to the what I'm copying now. So as you may notice, maybe when I'm drawing, it's more like a bit older. Little bit, and the tail's the same. I use the same technique, and blending it, make it more transparent, and I think that's the idea. All right, so I'm coloring the background now. Here I'm still experimenting. You know, what kind of color should I do? Should I make it darker? You know, like sky blue, stuff like that. But it's not very important, because I just want to focus on Ariel here. Now I'm doing the splash. I decided to use the lasso tool, so it's easier for me. Make it faster to color, because it's just very organic. I don't need to really do it precisely. And then later on I have to take out or turn off the line work. I'm trying to blend it a bit. Make it darker. See here, I'm experimenting with the color balance. Just to see maybe the, because she's got this reddish orangish hair, and you know, would complement them is a bit of greenish color. Now I'm doing the rock. So I'm still in the middle of experimenting here. It's actually taken me longer than coloring Ariel, because here the Disney have this tradition of rendering the background more realistically than the character themselves, and I'm kind of try to follow that because that's how it should feel. So still doing a lot of quick texturing here using different brushes, adding different color, some reflective light there, a bit of bluish highlights, you know, some details. I don't want to spend too much time on it. Once I'm happy with it, I just finish it up. And now I need to move the rock on the higher layer. And we're about to finish. I'm just as the adjusting stuff. Let's see what I need to do. And I think I'm still experimenting on this part. Yeah, I like the color. Splash. Seems nice. See. And now I decided to add my own thing instead of just, you know, I'm adding a bit of a darker part, a bit of shadow, and blush on her face, so she would look, oh, wow, so land. Things I would love to have, like feet, like in the song. Cool. Yeah, I think I'm done. What else do I need to do? Yeah, a bit more shadow. Try not to forget that. Even the tail, the hair. Also, I would like to turn this into 3D looking rendering when I had the chance again. Because that would be, it's not that easy, but it would be fun. Ah, that's it, I'm done. Thanks for watching this video, and I hope it helped you guys to also get inspired. Thank you again.